GSE member, Laura O'Grady, and GSE team leader, Patty Rooney.
On a serious note, I know you don't expect that from me, but on a serious note, I will say that Master Scott Keys was a very powerful and strong words that I put on in the British tune. I'm very pleased to come here today to talk with you about the Group Study Exchange Program. Group Study Exchange is really designed to introduce folks in a different country to our own culture here, and then to send a team from here into another country. That exchange part is very important because then it allows both groups to be able to share and understand what this process is all about. The Group Study Exchange team is generally made up of a team leader, who is a Rotarian, and then four young professionals who are not Rotarians, although we do hope that at some point in the future, Laura, they will consider becoming a Rotarian. You must be between 25 and 40 to be able to participate in the team and to be able to share the experience. The Group Study Exchange program used to be sponsored by the Foundation for Rotary. It no longer is. It's now being supported by individual districts. And last year, the governor made a very strong commitment to continuing the program, which was the first time it was supported by the district. And I've spoken with our current district governor before the meeting, and he has assured me that indeed the district will continue to support the Group Study Exchange program into the indefinite future.
Correct.
Indefinite future. Good. Our team was made up of myself as the team leader and 14 members. We had Amy, who is a teacher from Eastern School District. We had Teresa, who is a health worker who lives in Philadelphia but was working in Harrisburg. We have Jessica, who is an elementary teacher in Dover. Unfortunately, because the two teachers, it's very early in the school year, they were not able to be with us, but we were able to have Laura join us. I do want to recognize Tom Hoff is here from Carlisle Club. Tom is the district's outbound chair for the Group Study Exchange Program, and we very much respect and appreciate all the work that he did to prepare us for this trip. A word about Laura very quickly. Laura has been working at Martin Library since 2011. She is the Youth Services Librarian. She's a graduate from Central New York and a graduate from, I think, this small up-and-coming college called York College in history, and she has a master's from Pratt Institute. We're going to show you a very brief, overview of our trip to Argentina. We went, as you see, from District 7390, which is our district, to District 4855, which is actually in the province of Buenos Aires, but did not include the capital of Buenos Aires. And you'll see that. A very, very large district. Actually, the district itself is three times larger than the whole Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. So a massive area extending from the outskirts of the capital of Buenos Aires all the way down to the pampas. And you're going to see some of that. We visited four major towns in the area. And I must say, we're heartily welcomed by all the various Rotarians. One of the things that I know that Laura's going to talk about, you have to understand, and Bert and I have talked about this, the Argentinians run on Argentinian time. So when the meetings for our Rotary presentations were supposed to begin at 9 p.m., we sat down for dinner around 10:30, and got up to make our presentations sometimes around 11:30 p.m. And the folks would be a little upset if you left before 1 a.m. Because they considered that to be quite early. So it was quite a different experience culturally just to get used to doing your presentations. But the wonderful thing about all the rugby clubs, whether it was a lunchtime meeting, we went to many of those, or the evening meetings, is they served spectacular wine from the Mendoza region of Argentina, and good, right? Yeah, we drank a lot of it. I'm going to have Laura take over. Thank you.
What happens in everybody?
bottom picture is actually when they were at this club, and we actually got to meet each other, which, as they understand, is a rare opportunity that the teams get to overlap and see each other before they go, which was really cool. We had one of the girls, this is my name, she's like, oh my god, my parents want spaghetti in English, you're going to have so much fun. So it was really fun. So a little bit about Argentina. Our capital is Buenos Aires, as Patty said, but it's actually a whole province, so it's a very large population. It's just over 42 million, GDP 746 billion. Total area is over 1 million square miles, and the currency is the Argentine peso. So our first trip was in Jose Cepaz, and this, it might have been because this is where we first arrived, but I found this area and its people to be so warm and welcoming that it kind of set the standard really high for the rest of the trip. On our left, I know people in the back can't see very closely, but these are the Rotarians. So those are Rotarians, and the man in the red shirt was my host father. His name was Alberto Marinelli, and he exemplified what I imagined the cultural Rotarian to be. A very good man. He once said to me, he only spoke Spanish, so his poor daughter Carolina got him to go ahead and translate everything. But he said, if you ask a Rotarian for $1, they'll give you $5. He really told me what Rotarians, folk Rotarians are, and it was really eye-opening for me. The middle picture is my group with Carolina in the middle. Carolina did not know she was going to be a translator for the entire week, but she became one. And she was my host's sister, and I know Roberta as a sister in general, because she became very close to me on our trip, but became very close to the whole group. She told me that she actually wanted to be a translator, but she didn't think she was smart enough, so she was just going to be an English teacher. And I think that this changed her whole perspective on her belief in herself, and the amount of giving that back and forth can happen when translated. I know I'm sort of trying to tell you a quick story. On the ride into Buenos Aires City, we were playing hangman, and we were teaching each other words through playing hangman. And Amy said, do something very Pennsylvanian. So I did shoot my pie. And so Karen could not get it. She said, I don't know what this word is. And I said, here's a hint, it's something you eat. And so then I kept filling the letters, and she looks at me, she says, you eat shoes and pies? I died. Amy got died, and the whole beat was cracking up the train. Everyone's looking their foot wrong, but we got along so famously that it made a lot of future happen. So the first weekend we went to Estancia, which is a big ranch, essentially. Learned a lot about the Argentine culture, gauchos, food. Horseback riding, we actually got to hear Argentine music, and they played music from all the nationalities that were in the room. It was a big touristy thing, so there were lots of people from all over the world. And Patty, I think, was the lone Englishman in the room, and they played Let It Be for him. And they played the Saints Go Marching In. And so we all sang, it was so much fun. We really got close to this first group of Rotarians. One of the last school visits, on the left is a private school that we visited. It's actually the school of Melanie, who was the team leader for the Argentine team. We got to sit down and talk to the teams about their perceptions of the United States and the importance of travel and all that we can learn from each other. On the right-hand side of the public school, and as you can see, the public and the private school look very different. Argentina has interesting challenges and benefits, and the education is free in Argentina, even through secondary school. But what we talked to a lot of people about is they take advantage of all the free education, but then they leave the country. So there's a lot of interesting challenges that I said before about how to keep young, smart, talented kids in the country and make Argentina have a better future. And what was really cool, as I said about the family I was with, we would sit down for dinner, which, as Patty said, lasted 3 or 4 hours, and talk about everything, talk about politics and government and culture. And there, the Argentine people are so passionate and open and wants to share experiences with you. So I've learned so much, and that is where I went to the exchange for the group study exchange. Week two is going to be Julio. The band leading this group is Alberto on the left. Julio is a very different town from Jose Cepaz, much more affluent. So we got to see that one town does not represent all of Argentina. Obviously, we know that when we saw the first band. This is the first time that we met the German team who was going to be traveling with us for the rest of the so it was a very different dynamic to go from the first week in a small group to the second week, third, and fourth week, being about 15 large when you would go from place to place in a bus. food and drink, there's none better, I'm convinced. Asada on the left is kind of a gruesome picture, but it's strapped to like sheet metal and over wood flame, and it was delicious. We talked to a bunch of the other team members on our team, and they were saying, no, they don't use a lot of spices, they don't use a lot of flavorings, but it's because it's so good in its essential form that it doesn't need much else. So flame grilled meat was basically how we eat for whole month. And there's flame grilled meat with white bread and Malbec, that was my entire diet, with some dulce de leche also. So we went to another Sunset and had a carne asada. In the middle, we did wine tastings. There's no better Malbec in the world, which is fine with me because that's delicious. And on the right hand side, well, the pastry and sweet things. Dulce de leche is not the dulce de leche I've tasted in the United States. It's much creamier and richer. And they put it on everything for breakfast. So sure, I'll make candy for breakfast. And so that's what they did. On the bottom right is mate. And mate is a tea that they drink constantly. Mate time is like when you sit down, you have a cup of mate and a mate cup, and there are bombichas, kind of a straw that sits inside of it, and you pass it around the table. So it's a communal experience. Tell me about your day. And there's very strict rules about how to drink the mate cup without grossing out the people we are with. You know, like putting alcohol over and stuff like that. It's very strict rules. And Alberto told me very passionately over like 3 bottles of Malbec about how to drink mate. So I have written instructions. He made me write down the instructions, so I can tell you. This is a native herb, and it was strange to put a presentation, but everywhere we went, our top tour guide would say, and that's the ombu. And by the end of it, like, we know, we've heard about the ombu. It's actually an herb. It's not a tree at all. It's a bush, but that's gigantic. So in the Pampas region, there's no native trees, no native trees at all, but there's the ombu, which actually is a tree. So just a fun fact. Vegetation. This is our district conference. It's not your everyday district conference. They had it in, recently at a castle. And so it was a beautiful day, and it was autumn in May, so it was a crisp autumn day at this estancia, which is actually looking like a castle. And we got to do a presentation alongside. The German team also did a presentation, and all of the high schools that had done exchanges that were there. It was a really fun day, and it was part of our downtime, so we had a few days in a hotel, and in the city of Lobos, which is where the Mr. Conference was, and we got to hang out, regroup, and sort of get back on the same page, plan our presentation. It was really nice time. We have cruises in Mercedes, so on the left-hand side, you can see that it is turning on, and this is the church in the town. Every town had a town square. There was the church, the bank, and the municipal building. And so everywhere we went to the church, like a beautiful moment. And this was a particularly beautiful church, so happy when I got the chance to pull it out here. But Mercedes, we had lovely families that we stayed with. On the left, Amy and Jess stayed with Susanna and Alberto. And Alberto was in charge of organizing the whole week with some sort of pneumonia going on. So he was so lovely and really dedicated to our experience. And on the right, Reese, who was short of Teresa, and I stayed with Carlos and Norma. We were so warmly welcomed by them that was the world's way to put it this trip, because these people are kind, open-hearted, lovely people. So as I said, when you went to any town, you visited the municipal building, the church, and the bank. And so here's the municipal building. On the bottom right-hand side, we're with the mayor. And you can also see the German team. So on the right-hand side is the German team. We were very lucky that the German team spoke Spanish, German, and English. So we could converse with them very easily. And they could help us both with what's going on in Spanish and other things. So they were wonderful to be with and super nice people. And I couldn't say enough good things about them. Their team leader was Annabelle, and she was a lovely woman as well. Here we are at the courthouse. Alongside there was a district judge. I always get back on that papers on the desk. I don't know how to get anything done. But we visited the judge and learned a little bit about what his role is in the Mercedes. I got to talk with them about the challenges and the difficulties that they face as a municipality and then as a province and ultimately as a country. On the right hand side, we have to visit Oporia, which is kind of like a Wild West saloon. So all of it was left intact. It's where people would dock, there was water, water right nearby, and then they would come in, get a beer and food. And there was a lot of old knickknacks on the wall. And so we got to sit there, have drinks and churipan, which is chorizo, in the white bread, which is my favorite cooking, and cheese, and just listen to them tell about what the culture was, the actual culture, its history. And some things got lost in translation sometimes. They said there were never fights in the culture, yeah, but they would argue with knives. So I think that one was good. But I always had a kick out of all of the trying to understand each other, coming up with clever ways to help each other understand what we were saying, using gestures or pointing or saying words that we didn't know and then making gestures to enhance that word. We had so much fun. And I think that while it was definitely challenging to learn the language, we broke down barriers a lot more because we could laugh at each other and try to work through the barrier. Here we are at St. Patrick's Church in Mercedes, San Patricio, when we were down there. This was an incredible day. So we got a private tour of this church. It basically looks like a cathedral in my mind. I don't even call it a church. And they have the oldest functioning pipe organ in South America. And since we were there by ourselves, they got to really work on it and make it loud and play these awesome songs. They let us go up to the pipe organ, and since I was crazy, I got to go climb behind the pipes up really high up and then with all the dust and hear what it's the vibrations of my goes. It was so cool. They played Ave Maria, they played the Wedding March, a lot of other things. And then we then got to go out on these buttresses on the side and climb all the way up to the bell tower. And they left here, the bell tower wasn't going up. It was so cool. And it was like 10:37, so all the town people were like, what is happening? But they let me climb up inside the bell, and I have a picture of that. But we had so much fun at this church. And a priest came up to me, didn't know where I was, and says, you have a map of Ireland on your face. And my last name is O'Grady, and I know I had never said that to you before, but I said, well, me llamo O'Grady. And he said, oh, me llamo O'Brien. So even in Argentina, someone referenced my culture and history, and we had an experience with people with that, you know, halfway around the world. It was very cool. My grandma loved it. So that week, we also went to a lot of different Rotary clubs. We did about 6 or 7, and as Patty said, we did lunch runs, and then we did ones that went until like 1 o'clock in the morning. So for some of them, we were up there kind of asleep and saying our thing, but everyone was so appreciative of us. We met so many wonderful people, and I enjoyed actually really banging out all these presentations. We had a lot of fun because we got really good at our Spanish. This is a day trip we took to a town called San Antonio Areco. We went to a silversmith, a chocolatier, and an artist's workshop. Quickly, the chocolate, a apple horn, as you see there, an apple horn is the most wonderful little dessert in the world. It is 2 wafers with dulce de leche in the middle, with chocolate ganache on top. Oh my God, it's incredible. I brought many, many home with me, and determined to make them here, although I'm sure that they will be as delicious as they are there. Wuhan is another day trip. Mercedes. The city of Wuhan has this beautiful cathedral and a collection of Virgin Marys from around the world. So we got to see the different understandings and interpretations of the Virgin Mary and went on a tour with that. Had a love that day. It was fantastic. Our final city was Caseros Norte, and we arrived there on the 25th of May, which is kind of their Independence Day. They call it 25 de Mayo. And so we arrived to a Rotary Club, and they had a gigantic celebration with asado, as you can see. Lots and lots and lots of delicious meat. And on the left-hand side, my host family took us into Buenos Aires City to see the fireworks and the celebration. It was really, really cool. We also visited the university while we were there. At this, the university that has now been up and down left, we got to talk to students who were interested in studying abroad programs and give them our insight into why it's beneficial, the challenges, and what you can do to prepare for that. And that was a really cool experience for a lot of us. This is Buenos Aires City. We didn't get to spend a lot of time there, but it was really cool when we did. On the left-hand side is Galleria Pacifico, which is actually a mall, which has a really beautiful painted ceiling. And on the right-hand side is Camino, which is a street in the La Boca district, which is full of like Bohemian sort of artisan culture and really fun. And you can see it's identified by these bright colored buildings on the left hand side. On the right is us at a soccer stadium or football stadium. And in Argentina, we are a fan of one or two football clubs, either La Boca Junior or River Plate. And when we went to the Boca Stadium, our translator did not know we were going to a soccer stadium and said, well, I'm a River Plate, so I'm not going to translate anything on the store. And so she, it was all really fun, and she ended up doing it. But they take football very, very seriously. And so I just wanted to leave you with a quote, certainly travels more than the same sights. It is a change that goes on deep and permanent in the idea of living. And I want to end to tell you how grateful I am for this experience, because I do think it changed myself, changed my team members, and I think that we can make a better change on those that we have moving down.
So I know we're almost out of time, but I would want to say again, it was an amazing experience to be able to talk with our hosts and with many Rotarians that we met about the country, about the culture, and it's amazing what you can do with Google Translate. Because even though I was with families who often did not speak any English whatsoever, we had some amazing discussions, very intense discussions in fact, and it's a very, very powerful living experience to be able to share with them not only our own understanding of our culture here, but their culture as well. And of course, I want to give to President Al clubs. I think I have 11 or 12 banners here, various clubs that we